We're out here with Nick with the Batman hat. Don't have the hat on today, but we have the Batman shirt representing Batman. We have a special guest, DJ Seany Rob. We're here at the Octave Event Studio Group. Please enjoy the show, like and subscribe, and let's get into these questions. Before we get into these questions, would you mind in telling us your a little bit of your backstory, who you are?
Well, like Nick said, my name is DJ Seany Rob. My name's Sean Robbins. Pretty simple, Seany Rob. They've been calling me since I was a kid, so going into picking a DJ name is kind of simple. That's kind of where everybody knew me. That's what I roll with. I'm from Pottstown, PA, and actually my dad was a DJ years ago, so I always grew up around music, always knew music, but being a DJ never really a thought until a few years ago. But I was always an athlete, football, basketball, baseball, that's pretty much all I did.
That's how it all started. Nice.
Well, just being out with my sisters, and I constantly was saying, I can do better than that guy. Instead of saying, I can do. And the first thought I had was doing, you know, backyard cookouts, family events, that sort of thing, nothing major. I linked up with DJ Q-Ball, shout out to DJ Q-Ball. Once he had learned that I had an extensive knowledge of music, a bunch of different genres of music, he kind of pushed me more towards, hey, why don't you take it a little more seriously? So I took it a little more seriously, and I went from wanting to do backyard cookouts bar and that bar and this club and this wedding and this event. And boom, boom, here we are, 2018, and 60 weddings to do this year.
Oh man, 60 weddings, that's crazy. All right, so here we're gonna start with the first question. How did you get your idea or concept for your mixes? Did you listen to like everyday music, a thought, or how you said when you was growing up to get your mixes together?
A lot of different things. I think the number one key is knowing music and not just one certain genre of music.
You're kind of flexible.
Yeah, you have to, because 9 times out of 10, if you're walking into a bar, restaurant, or wherever you're playing, you're not just going to have one age group or one ethnicity group. The key is to keep everyone happy. I think I benefited growing up not limiting myself to certain genres of music. I listened to everything, even though only the recorded hip-hop and R&B on radio, or my CDs were hip-hop and R&B. It doesn't mean I didn't have an ear for, you know, other genres of music. I'd hear something maybe that smells like Teen Spirit when that came out. Now, I didn't let anybody know I liked it because it wasn't cool at the time.
Yeah, we all liked it. We're all like that.
But a few years later, when Papa Roach came out with Suffocation, and it was like, there were black people all over the school singing that song, and it was kind of like, yeah, like, you listen to a little rock and that's what you hear. You know, so yeah. Now, I incorporate that into my mixes, so I can go from hip-hop to country to rock, but it's all sewn together. So I can go from Steely Dan, that song called Do It Again. Jay-Z has a song called Do It Again. Try to match the lyrics up. Black Jack, do it again. We gonna do it again.
Okay.
You know, and that's how we can genre hop, but still making it flow.
Keep that energy level, keep going. Right. Yeah.
And some people catch it, and unfortunately some people.
That's how it is, man. All right, so the next question we have here for him: what makes you so passionate about music and creating these mixes for other people's entertainment?
Well, I would say music. I mean, without music, this world would be a big trouble.
Oh, I agree with that, because I need music.
It doesn't matter what the situation is with you know, going through the rough times and bad times. There's a song out there. There's millions of songs. There's one out there that will pick your spirits back up. And, you know, when people go out and, like happy hours, exactly what it is. Happy hour. Be happy. You know, most likely it's a Friday, getting ready to get the weekend started. You're out with coworkers or you met your friends after work. You go there and, you know, you're eating and drinking, but music is what sets the vibe. You know? And that's what I say to everybody who I sit down and talk to about booking weddings or milestone birthday parties. There's two things people remember: food and a DJ.
It's true. And if this is how I met him, because of the music, man. It was this flow, and I was like, you know what? Let me pay some respects, man.
I appreciate that.
Yeah.
One of my loyal followers right here is the name.
Always. Since, like, I don't remember, like, day one.
Absolutely. Well, really cool. But you know, just making people happy through your knowledge of music, because music is definitely that powerful. You know, you can make somebody's, you know, you're only supposed to get married once. And if people are constantly talking about your wedding and you're, you know, in your mind that when you look back to what your wedding was, man, we had a really good time. And that's And I'm always be a part of every wedding I've done. I'm going to be a part of them for the rest of their lives. And that's, you know, very rewarding. It makes it easy to
do what we do. That's a great bond right there, man. Through music. That's a great bond. Right. So our next question we have here for him: what is your ultimate goal for your DJing career?
So I know a lot of DJ goals is, a lot of people say, well, I want to play in this venue, that venue, I want to play in the big rooms, and I want to play at Regatta Casino, or I want to be a tour DJ for Lil Uzi Vert or whoever.
You know, yeah.
And that's not my vision. I don't do it for big venues and the recognition. I do it for reasons like I mentioned in the last question. I'd rather be a part of a wedding that's going to last forever than rocking the club every weekend. You know what I mean? Where there's different DJs, different people in and out.
Lost in the masses.
Right. I like providing, you know, memorable moments for couples, or if it's, you know, someone's grandma turned 70 or whatever. And I'm playing old school 60s and 70s music. You know, overall, my goal would be, you know, to just keep making memorable moments for people that I don't even know, and meeting, you know, new people and new relationships and friendships and things of that nature. But as far as the big, you know, playing the big rooms and all that, that's not what I'm in it for. I just want to, you know, be a part of memorable moments and have respect behind them.
That's good. That's deep. I like that. That's good. It's something to think about, you know? For all you upcoming DJ artists out there with music, something to think about. So, with the last question, we asked him what was his ultimate goal as a DJ and his DJ career. What actions have you taken in the past year or the last couple of months that get you further to that goal, to get that stronger bond with you?
I think just staying entrenched in the whole DJ culture and going and listening to other DJs and maybe turning on a radio station that you don't really listen to see what's on there, because you might hear something and an idea pop in your head like that. I was sitting at work the other day, and a guy got up and walked out the door, and the hinge made a certain noise, and I was like, it's in a song. I don't know what song it is, but it's in. And all day, I'm sitting there thinking, here, I come out with Wu-Tang and jump on. Just little things like that, you know what I mean? It's weird how that works, but, you know, listening to other DJs, listening to different music, and then applying it. You know, I, have subscribed to a DJ Scratch Academy, which helps you with the scratching and the cutting. And, it's a lot, definitely a lot you can do. Even equipment upgrades, you know, we've done a lot of that. I've done a lot of that in the past month, year.
Staying active.
Yeah, you got to, and it's tough because you got to juggle certain responsibilities in life, but you know,
sad but true.
If you want to reach your goal, then you don't want to. Because a lot of times, if you do a wedding, you get a referral from that wedding. So when you show up at the next wedding, when there's people from the last wedding, you want to put the same product out there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Because they'll be like, oh, I remember this is something from last
time. Right. So there's a lot of crate digging and forget about, and that's, you know, what I like to put in my sets every time I play, is, you know, I'm gonna play something that people say, man, I don't know that. It'll take you back to a time, might be a good time, might be a bad time, but it's gonna take you back, and somewhere in that set, I'm gonna get you. You know, hey, that man. Firsthand.
I know this very firsthand. He called me like, what? Let me slide on a dance floor real quick. So with the previous question, you said something, so with this question, I'm going to bring that back up. What do you do on a daily basis to keep yourself mentally focused regarding your DJing career? I know you said you hear the noise from like the hinge, bring up a song, but like, I know with like hard times, you know, because we all go through that, but like, what's that thing that keeps you keep going, keeps you focused? Like, you know, I'm going to do it.
Just knowing that nowadays there's, it's a lot easier to DJ nowadays because you don't have to lug around crates full of records. And I can get a computer and a controller and be a DJ. So you have to try to separate yourself from the DJs who don't have the musical knowledge and the skill that you have. And you want to make sure you're not with, you're not anywhere affiliated with them. You want to be up here, but to be up here, you got to work for it. You can't just go through the motions. You got to constantly stay on top because there's new stuff coming out, there's new songs coming out, there's old school samples that, you know, it's a lot. And like I said, piggybacking off the other question, it's just stepping out of your personal comfort zone of what you like. Listening to something that a guest might like. I might do there's weekends where I've done a Sweet 16 on Friday and then did a 75th birthday party on Saturday, you know, and everything in between. So you gotta find a way to be comfortable in every setting, no matter what the event is. And that means if you gotta throw on 98.1 WOGL and listen all day, that's what you gotta do. You know what I mean? And take a mental note or put it in your phone and get home to your computer and right now, how can I make this work with some other songs that I have, or try to get an original sample or something, and just trying to stay up, trying to stay current, but keeping everyone happy no matter the age.
That's good. Okay, so this question, this is one of the questions that we have here that I absolutely love to hear the experience and the emotion behind it. When you first started out DJing, when people were telling you you're not going to make it, it's not going to work, they say you're going to fail, what keeps you from listening to them and getting in that doubt moment saying, oh, I'm not going to do it, but keeps you moving forward to say, you know what, I'm not going to listen to you. I know I'll be successful in this.
Well, there is no doubt. If you trust and you believe in yourself, there is no doubt. And that's the motivation. I mean, you know, we've all heard the saying, like, hey, if you're motivated. That's just what it is. And I didn't personally take it as hate because I'm trying to look at it from their point of view. And when they found out that they just went around starting to DJ, the first thing that popped in their mind is, what's he know about music? He's a football player. And I'm trying to look at it from their mind, like, yeah, I can see it, but it's up to me to show them. You know what I mean? It's like, I understand where you're coming from. Just sit back. When the time comes, we'll see what happens. And it went from just that. It went from some people are curious, like, maybe, I guess. Then as you seen them first Fridays.
Those first Fridays was lit.
You couldn't move.
212 in Phoenixville, first Friday. It's, you just had to be there.
And it was a lot of the guys who, I don't want to say doubted, but were just curious, like, well, maybe, it might work. And then every first Friday, first Friday. Yeah. And my phone was going off the hook once they found out 212 was closing. I'm like, oh, really?
Yeah.
Not rocking the club anymore. Nah. You just have to book me for your own party.
Hey, that's going to have to, that's how the ball rolls sometimes. Yeah,
never let the haters get you down. It absolutely is motivation. And that goes along with what keeps you motivated and inspired to do better and achieve more than what you've already achieved.
Listen, this question is going to piggyback again from the previous question regarding your goal and your ultimate goal. Once you achieve that goal, everyone is talking about you from weddings, different social events, birthdays, and you're up there, you know, that peak, you know. What are your plans after you achieve that? You're known throughout the towns, areas. Excuse me. What are your plans after that? Just keep doing the same thing or trying yourself different?
I think with what my goal is, there's a new ceiling. There's no sky. There is no... If your goal is to be a tour DJ and you finally accomplish that, well, you're already at the roof. You can only come back down. You know what I mean? You want to say, I want to play in the Tropicana or the Borgata, or I want to go to New York and play in big clubs or wherever. And once you get there, then it's like, all right. But with my goals, they're the ceiling. The sky's the limit. Keep going up, because you're always going to make memories, no matter who it is, no matter what event you're doing. I'm working hard to make sure that the event's a success. And I know going into these, when I first started, it was, someone's probably going to like it, or I don't know, it's just, an older couple that maybe can't relate to me. And now it's like, wait for this event. I'm gonna kill it. I'm gonna love it. And I'm gonna get so many referrals off of it. And I'm gonna go on Wedding Wire and Facebook and leave a great review. So I think not having that one goal that you want to reach and your goal is the sky, then the question's irrelevant, really. You know.
Good, man. That's a different answer. Never gotten that before. I like that. That's good. You said this before, but just in case someone didn't catch it or grasp the concept of it, what do you do, or do you study more in the DJing field to get yourself ahead of the game? Like you say, you might turn on the radio one or might hear a noise, something like that. But for somebody who didn't catch it, do you actually take time to study in the field to get a little bit further?
Absolutely. I mean, when I have a night off, I'm going to see a DJ. Someone who I haven't heard in a long time, or I haven't heard at all, period. Because every DJ can teach you something. Even a DJ who's not as polished or experienced as I am, he might play a song that I forgot about. And that one song might lead to another five songs, or it might lead to six or seven routines, who knows? Now, you might not be able to teach me anything technical-wise, but you might pull something out of his library. I'm like, oh, man. And the flip to that is, you go see an experienced DJ and watch them do something that I may not be that great at, which is, cutting and scratching and all that, which I'm currently practicing. I want to get a little bit better just to add a little flair to my set. But definitely go and see other DJs, whether with the internet. And if I can't get there live, then, YouTube.
And it's true.
You can YouTube it. Millennial YouTube. You can always YouTube. And number. You're not going to better yourself as a DJ without practice. And that's something that I, in 2018, I want to step up a little more. It's practice. Because you can always get better. I know all the DJs who've been DJing 25, 30 years, they practice. I had somebody at the gym the other day say, yeah, man, Harry Patterson for the biggie barbecue, and like looked down and they're like, still practices. Yeah. Daily. You know, how do you think he's as good as he is? He practices. He's like, wow, that's amazing. I said, hey, Jazzy Jeff practices. I showed him a video of Jazzy Jeff trying to learn a different kind of scratch, and it didn't sound good at all. I'm like, this is the magnificent. And he's struggling. You know what I mean? Practice, practice, practice.
Gives you something to think about. All right, everyone. Now we're down to my favorite question. My favorite question. Second favorite question.
True.
Call it that second favorite question. If you could choose to be any superhero, why and who would it be? Well, who would it be and why?
Well, I think the current moment has to be Black Panther.
Black Panther was hot. It was hot. Go see it.
It has to be. There's no other choice right now. It has to be. And I think the main reason is because growing up, we grew up, African American, we're not used to seeing an African American hero. You know what I mean? So even the build up to this, and I'm not a huge like Marvel fan. Like I know of him. My brother's a bigger Marvel fan than I am, and he's got me into it over the past 9 or 10 years or so. But the hype and the build-up is like, and I don't even go to the movies. I might go once every 3-4 years. I think the last movie I've seen was Straight Outta Compton. I don't blame you.
I watched that drone. I'll stream that thing. Like, yo, you know how much money it costs for a ticket? Yo, yeah, son.
It's not talking about the popcorn. This was one that definitely it was must see. You had to see because it was something that we're not used to seeing. Mm-hmm. Growing up, it was always Batman or Superman. It was never African American coming the same day. So I think right now it is definitely Black
Panther. Nice.
I don't know if that's a cop out answer, but that's my answer.
Not a cop out. Go watch the movie. Pay attention to it because this is, and if anyone was paying attention, Blade does not count. He does not count. This movie was all African Americans. Blade was just one character. I mean, I give it to him, but still, like this, just go watch it, man.
You don't need to be a Marvel fan. It's a good movie if you're a Marvel fan or not.
And I'm a Marvel fan, but I also DC. I'm kind of a little bit of both, but this, you have to give it its credits. Its credits due, and it broke the box office in the UK, so deal with it. This question here, I like to put this question here because what these questions are for you guys who are watching this, but this one is for you, just for yourself, for the future. You're feeling down because I always get those moments, you're feeling down. It's like I need to be inspired, but you like have a hard time being inspired. What words of self-affirmation do you have for yourself in the future to look back on this video? So when you're feeling down or something hits you and you just feel rock bottom, what words can you say to yourself to bring you back and get re-inspired again to keep moving forward?
I would say, don't listen to the naysayers. Block them out and, trust in yourself and in your talents. You're talented. You really have a gift. And, just stay true. Stay true to yourself. Stay true to your goals and your dreams and aspirations and where you want to go with this. And only thing that matters is if you have the confidence in yourself. It doesn't matter what your confidence is in me, what his confidence is in me, what your confidence is in me. I have the confidence within myself and I know what I'm capable of doing. It's just staying in that mood and bringing it out. And just trusting in yourself and staying true.
Make sure you pay attention in the future because we don't know how long it goes. How long? Hopefully you don't have to watch this when you're done. Just watching just to watch it. But listen, man, this is yourself talking to yourself.
stay positive. I've always been a glass half full. Everybody always says, man, positive in every situation. It doesn't matter what situation it is, you can probably pick a positive out of almost every situation. And that's what I look for in this situation.
Life, so true.
Life's too short. It's too short. And then my high school football coach used to say it to us all the time, God rest his soul, keep sweat. We say, why are we here on this earth for a short period of time? You're older, and now you're starting to realize, man, he was right. There's people who came and gone years, a thousand years ago. You know, this earth's been around for a while, and only here a short period of time. So I would say, I know you're going through some things, but you gotta stay positive. You have to stay positive because someone always has to work. There's somebody right now making plans for tomorrow that I'll never see the plans. Stay positive. Gotta stay positive. Glass is always full.
It's true. Stay positive. Now, I went through some stuff too, but we'll make a different video for that. But this one's just been. It's good. Pay attention, man. It's always good to be positive. Always a positive in any situation. It's true. Now, this question here is for you guys who's watching this. And thank you for watching. If you've been watching this completely all the way through, thank you so much. Please like and subscribe. But this question here, what words of inspiration would you give to future DJs who are looking to be in this career or having a hard time trying to attain a career like this? Not all the lights and glitter or cameras that they see, but starting up from the ground. Like, what kind of words you have for them to just keep going and stay inspired?
First of all, definitely go for it. Don't second guess yourself. Go for it. Now, with that, there comes some things you're going to have to do. You're going to have to put in the work. You have to know that you need to practice. You can't just buy equipment and go out and play. It doesn't work like that. People don't need to see the product. So, you have to practice. When I first got everything hooked up, set up in the dining room, actually, I told my barber, get into DJing. I told him this before I even had any equipment. I said, yo, I'm thinking about starting getting into DJ. And the next time I went in to get my hair cut, he said, yo, I want to DJ my wedding. It's before I had any equipment. I didn't have any equipment. And a lot of DJs, like, I keep bringing Q-Ball up. That's my guy.
Hey, man.
He's been doing this almost 30 years. And he was 3 years deep before he did his first wedding. My first gig was a wedding.
Wow.
Yeah. So once I got everything hooked up, I locked myself in the house. And for a whole month, all I did was practice. What does this do? What does that do? Trying to mix with your ear, one in, one out. Practice. You definitely got to put the time in. Nothing. All these DJs you see out here that are legitimate and they got gigs every weekend, in and out, every weekend, all month, all year. It doesn't come just from buying equipment. You gotta put the work in. You gotta work. Also, and this is one of the main things, you cannot play what you wanna play. Alright? Let me get that to you again. You cannot play what you wanna hear. You can't do that. You have to keep the whole room engaged, and you gotta keep everyone here. So if I'm looking around the room, you might see a young Caucasian couple here, an older African American couple here, middle-aged Hispanic couple over here. All right, what can I play to keep them all in the room and bob their head or tap their toe and have a good time? Now, if I just want to play what I want to hear, they want to get up and walk out. Finish the drink and get up and leave.
I've seen this happen with other DJs before. Absolutely. I've seen it, like, I ain't gonna lie, it was one spot a while back. I'm like, you know what? Let's go to a different spot.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. That's one of the major keys. Another thing I would say is request for some DJs who are kind of like, this is what I do, you take requests, because then people, you get to interact with people and they can see, hey, he's not just a good DJ, he's a good personality. So that's one of the major things. One of the DJs told me, he said, look, man, I took a lot of bad advice when I started, but what I'm telling you, take requests. Take requests from whoever, whenever, wherever. And back to the genre thing, don't ever limit yourself. I mean, get as much music as you can from every different era, every different genre, and try to make it all fit and tie together. You don't just go from, you know, slow lane to fast lane. Like that, and the turn signals on, you know what I mean? Make a rhyme or reason to it. Definitely gotta have the passion for it. If you don't have the passion for DJing, then I would say, I'm gonna try it. You know, you gotta love what you do. Because if not, then you're just gonna be going through the motions, playing the same song every week or whatever, and you're gonna burn out, and otherwise, I'm gonna win. You don't love it and you're not in it, and you're not going to be creative, and it's not going to spin like mine spins. I'm at work all day, like, what can I do next? What routine can I put together? And switch to this station and see what, you know, constantly staying on top of things. And if you don't have that kind of drive, it's not really a DJ career, it's not going to last. So, you know, don't worry about the doubters and the naysayers. Stay up on your music, all different kind of genres. Don't play what you want to hear. Go for it. Go for it.
That's good stuff. Again, thank you all for watching and liking the video. Please like and subscribe. Please make sure you check out. It's going to be somewhere around here. All his social media platforms. Go check him out. I've been following him for, I have no idea how long. Thank you again for joining us. Again, we're at the Octave Event Group Studio. There we go. We got it out here. But again, thank you again.
Thank you, brother. Appreciate it.
And please like and subscribe and go follow him, man. One of the great DJs I've ever heard. Number one on my list.
Appreciate that. Much appreciate it.
And stay tuned, because we're going to have some footage of the studio, so you can check it out. Sure. Thank you again. And like and subscribe.
He's going to come to an event.
Yes. Yes, he will.
Rock the house.
All right, man. Well, thanks, and stay tuned. Show a little bit of footage, and enjoy. Talk to you guys soon. See you next time. Peace.